I'd like to do my favorite Christmas song of all the ones I've recorded.
I'll have a blue Christmas. Just thinking about decorations of red on a green Christmas tree. Won't be the same day.
Hello, I'm Bernie Leaving, Congregational Care Pastor here at Palma City United Methodist, and it is my delight to welcome you to this week's PrayerCast. Today is December the 21st, marking the winter solstice, which happened this morning at 5:44 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. In the Northern Hemisphere, it is the shortest day and the longest night of the year. This morning, the Northern and Southern Hemispheres traded places, really, in receiving the sun's light and warmth. So it is the Southern Hemisphere's longest day and shortest night. The reality of the longest night has prompted many churches to hold a longest night service to provide opportunity for the light of God's presence to shine into the lives of people for whom there is not much light or joy to match the cultural Christmas mood of joyous music and bright lights. Many churches have begun to call it a blue Christmas service, which reminds me of Elvis Presley's song in which he sang, "I'll have a blue, blue Christmas without you. I'll be blue just thinking about you. Decorations of red on a green tree won't be the same, dear, if you're not here with me." Such services are planned especially for anyone who is feeling out of touch with the holiday cheer due to the absence of a special love or the presence of an illness ravaging the body, or when the reality hits the rent or mortgage or electric bill cannot be paid, let alone presents bought for the family, or when yet another Christmas party means he will come home again drunk, or when you are worried about the direction in which our country is going, or when the depression is just simply too much for you to bear. The first Christmas with an empty chair at the table is especially difficult. For folks trying to smile and say, "Merry Christmas," is more than difficult. C.S. Lewis once wrote, and I quote, "No one ever told me that grief felt so much like I'm not afraid, but the sensation is like being afraid. The same fluttering in the stomach, the same restlessness, the yawning." With the reality of our nation's armed forces' continued deployment in Afghanistan and Iraq and other volatile places around the globe, their families may feel like Eleanor Roosevelt did in December 1942 when she wrote in a newspaper column, "How completely the character of Christmas has changed this year. I could no more say Merry Christmas to you without a catch in my throat than I could fly to the moon." Interestingly enough, even the first Christmas was not a joyful time, and the story of Jesus' birth is not to be told with a jolly voice and a ho, ho, ho. It is the story of an unmarried, pregnant, teenage girl. It's the story of a child born in a dirty animal stall. It's the story of a refuge family fleeing to keep their child from being killed. It is the story of one sent into the world as the Prince of Peace, who was condemned to death. It is the story of a light sent to shine in the darkness which was snuffed out by the cross. We cannot come to the manger without acknowledging that it always stands in the shadow of the cross. In the daily calendar of the saints, today is the feast day of Saint Thomas. You remember Thomas, the apostle who could not believe it when he was told Jesus was alive, because for him, the cross had blotted out all possibilities of hope and light and life. He said, "Unless I see, unless I touch, I will not believe." And Jesus came and said, "Here, Thomas, see, touch, do not doubt, believe." And Thomas, all he could say was, "My Lord and my God." My friend McGray DeVega, senior pastor at Hyde Park United Methodist, wrote in his midweek message last week that in spite of how strange it may seem that today is designated as the feast day for St. Thomas, maybe he is the perfect saint for the longest night. McGray said that Jesus, in showing Thomas his wounds, was saying, "Look, you wanted to believe in a God who could avoid death and suffering. I'm showing you a God who identifies with you in suffering and can lead you through it. These pierced hands and feet are evidence that this God whom you worship can connect with you in your deepest pain and lead you to a new and living hope." So if on this winter solstice, shortest day and longest night, you are of heavy spirits and shattered dreams, if you are living with a broken heart and deep wounds, know that you do not have to keep a stiff upper lip and pretend that everything's fine. You do not have to grit your teeth and endure the holidays. You can own your sadness. You can acknowledge your insecurity. You can claim your loneliness, knowing that God loves you and knows your name. Knowing God sent a child into this world that you might each know you are God's child, and that God sees your suffering, your doubt, and your pain, and comes to be with you, to redeem you, to empower you, to strengthen you, and to give you peace. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. God, thank you for coming among us in our longest nights, for claiming us as your children, and shining the light of your love into our darkness. Amen. God bless the rest of your week. Hope to see you in one of our 6 Christmas Eve services at Palmacia. Go to our website for the times of those services. There will be 1 service on Christmas Day at 11 a.m. And if you feel the need to gather with others who may be dealing with their own struggles, to claim the dark sadness and shadowy pain in your life, Hyde Park United Methodist will be hosting a Blue Christmas service tonight in their chapel on Platt Street. The service is open to the community. Merry, Merry Christmas to all of you.